I think the bigger question that I've always been trying to understand is why aren't people invested in York? And then more specifically, why aren't young black and brown people invested in York? Why do they feel like this is not the place to be? And so my biggest thing is, how can I be a beacon to show them that they should be invested in York? How can I do different things, be involved in different organizations? That's why I'm downtown as much as I am, just hopefully be a beacon to young people, but also black and brown people, to, like Inclusive Arts always says, connect cultures through the arts. That's the biggest reason.
I love my community, and I would like to see my community further itself along and be more inclusive and diverse.
I moved to the area in 2008 thinking I'd probably only be here for about 2 years and move on to something bigger and better. But through my work in the newspapers, I got to really know this community, and once I left the newspapers, realized that I wanted to be more involved in it. I was meeting people on some of the worst days of their lives, and I still saw hope and what this community had to offer.
I'm invested in York because it's where I live. We have a lot going for us here in this community, and we also have a tremendous amount of untapped potential still to explore. I grew up here in York. I was not the kind of kid who couldn't wait to get out of my hometown, but I also, it never occurred to me that I would stay here as an adult. And then I moved home to have my son, and now I can't imagine having raised him anywhere else.
Now I own a house, and I'm dating a guy who was born and raised in Railroad, and I don't know if that means I'll ever get out.
One of the things that really keeps me vested in York is my family's generosity in the community. My grandmother was one of the first people in my family who started volunteering in the community, started volunteering for an organization that is now my daily bread. She started out at San Cristo Salvador Church in on South Street. She spent years cooking lunch and breakfast for the community, and my parents volunteered there a lot. So we come from a volunteer family, and we love to help our community. And this is a community we're invested in. My family's been here since the early 60s. So, and I was born here in 66. So I really love this community, and I want to make sure that I leave a legacy in this community of doing good things for people.
The youth are like, what's our future? And we all know that seems so cliche, but if we're not connecting to them, then what are we doing for what comes after us? What are we leaving them? And I have two sons, so I want to make sure my sons see me and see other, you know, black people in a better light than what they've been seeing, so that they know they have bright futures ahead of them and they have hope.
It's a really great place to get involved. You can roll your sleeves up. You can bring something new to the community, and people will support it. And I love that I've had the opportunity to set that example for my son.